What's up, guys? I'm Aaron Heeb. I work for Loud Production Group, and today I'm just in the shop. Tonight I'm just in the shop hanging out, working on some time code stuff and just building a file that I've been working on for a little bit. And I kind of want to run through that file and how I set it up, just some basic stuff on how I set it up, as well as really the point of this video is just how to set up time code. At least my favorite way to set up time code with a Grandome 2. And yeah, I mean, that's really it. That's just the basics of it. And I want to run through why I do this the way I do. So first, I want to just walk through software and hardware. So right here, I have Reaper. This is also very easy to do with like Ableton or... I mean, Ableton's probably going to be the most used way in like the touring side of things, or FL Studio you can do this, or whatever. Honestly, any digital audio workstation. So we have, obviously, Reaper. I have my laptop. It has an i7 processor, and it's touchscreen, so I like it a lot for lighting and stuff. I also have a Focusrite 2i4 audio interface, then a basic gigabit switch, and then a fogger for fun. Then we have a Grandome 2 light. This is something we're renting for some gigs that we have coming up, and I'm just working on my MA2 files with it because it's a lot easier to work on these files with a physical console than it is to with out a physical console, really. So then we also have an ArtNet node. You don't need this for running lights per se. I also just have this little package set up because I'm just really I'm wanting to test these ADJ Visi CMY300s that we're running for a couple shows. Then we just have some lights that we have chilling at the shop just set up to play with as well, so I'm not bored. So yeah, that's really as far as it goes with hardware and software. So yeah, I'll go into how I have this set up. Okay, so first we'll start with the Reaper setup. In Reaper, which is a free to try for 60 days, and then it's still beyond my 60 days, and I'm still able to use it, but I'm planning to buy a license just because I want to support Reaper, because this is a really useful tool. You'll go to, not options, you'll go to Insert, SMPTE LTC, MTC Timecode Generator, and then you'll also insert your tracks or whatever you're using for timecode, or timecoding too. And so I'll go to, I have my timecode generator right here, and source properties, I'm sending LTC. You can also do MTC or MIDI, and I use that. I'll switch back and forth between the two. I'll use LTC when I have a physical console, and I'll use MIDI when I'm doing like a loopback, which I will also link a video from Christian Jackson on how to do that with MA with your own PC. And just this will be a useful piece of hardware or software if you wish to do that. It's just called Loop MIDI, and it's free. Very useful. So I just have a couple tracks and some markers for my track. And I am sending my tracks out to just the right channel, and my timecode generator just out to the left channel. And I have it routed with a new hardware. Or a hardware output. Don't know why I said new there. And that hardware output is set up. Oh my goodness, focus. I'll go to options, go down to preferences, and have it set up as my output device, which is Scarlett 2i4. That's my Focusrite Scarlett. And yeah, have that set up. And so my first output, which is routed to my left side, is right here, which is sending time code. My right is just right here. It's just an aux cord going to a speaker. And the setup from that cabling is going for the left side, which is my timecode generator, is just going to the back of the console in the LTCN. So that is pretty much the entire setup to running timecode. For some reason, my computer is not connecting to the session with the MA, with MA on PC. So I'll just run through how MIDI could work with it. So if I opened up, that's why I'd have this switch here, other than to run up to the ArtNet node. But if I open this and I was in session, then if I had over here, I had set up options, miscellaneous, and if I had, or actually MIDI, and I had my MIDI in device to be that loop MIDI, which I just have this named as, I have a loop back named as MA2 timecode pool, and that's my PC internal on this show file, and I was running it from that in session with my computer as the master to the console, then I'd be able to run MIDI timecode, if that makes sense. But I think it's more reliable in this instance to just run LTC, so I'm running SMPTE through LTC. Okay, so now I'll just do like a quick little snippet of something so I don't get demonetized, but I'll show how I would actually use this in the real world. So I have a song by Lucky Lee. I have a little bit of a buffer before it just to make sure everything in the lighting world catches up with it. So that is my song one on here. So I have a macro right here. I'll just hit song one and watch as it sets everything up for me. Sets up this page with all my presets, and it sets up this page with my sequence and everything like that, and my timecode clock. So I make sure that I am running the correct timecode, which this one is labeled for SMPTE. That's my LTC from the back, and there is PC internal as well, but we're not gonna mess with that because that's not what we are using. So I'll just run through a couple quick cues, get a little fog. So yeah, we'll just hit spacebar here to start the song. We got that buffer, and you can see that we are getting time code down here. And look at that, we have cues running. Cool, gonna turn that off before I get demonetized. Cool. And yeah, here we go. We'll run into my setup on MA. So I have a series of macros that will run. So say I'm touring with a band and they have song one is what they always start with. And sometimes instead of song two being the next song, they play song three. I can just say the song ends, I can go over, hit song three, and I'm set up and ready for song three. Not only on this page, but also on this page with my presets and all that jazz. So if something were to change slightly, or I was just wanting to program a couple things really quickly before the show, then I'm set up. The other thing that these macros switch over is my timecode pool. So I like to have a different pool for each song, so that I can just set the offsets and then I'm good to go. So it'll switch over the timecode pool and it will go that timecode pool, which is really important. So cool, we have that set up and we have a macro base set up for that. So I will just take a second here to set that up and show you that macro. Cool, so this macro is, it's not super difficult. It's kind of daunting with how many steps there are in it, but it is a really simple macro once it gets down to it. So we'll start with the first line is just off page 1 through 99. That's going to turn off everything on your execute pages or your fader pages technically, as well as your bank of executors down here. And then next we have set variable and user variable current song, which equals song one. And we'll have to change that if we change everything else to
whatever we want it to be named, but right now I keep it as Song 1, just because I have no reason not to. So yeah, that just sets your user variable throughout everything as Song 1. So we'll go to page current song, which is Song 1, and that is what we name this page over here. And then top executor is current song, which is, again, Song 1. Select executor, current song, again, Song 1. So we have to make sure that this executor and our page and anything with that variable is named exactly what we put as our user variable, which is current song, Song 1. Cool. And then fader 1 at 100, so that means that fader, which is our main sequence fader, is at 100. And then go to cue dot or 0.5, which is our mark or standby cue. Off time code 1 through. That is going to turn off all of these time code pools. And then back at our macro, we want top time code current song, which is also Song 1 or whatever we have our user variable set to. And then select time code current song, same thing, it's just selecting that time code pool. And then we have go time code current song, which is just to go that time code pool, which basically means on here to select the play button, not because some it'll usually default to being paused, but we want it to play, so that's go. Otherwise, our timecode will not be playing when we hit that. And then after that, I have this is kind of the trickier part. It's assign view 101 at view button 1.1 screen 2. So screen 2 right here, that's the screen. This is our view that we want to call to view button 1.1. So this is view button 1.1 right here. And so let's go down and I'll show you my views. So down here, we have a view for each song that'll go to view button 2, or screen 2, view button 1.1. So it'll just recall 101. View 101 recalls at view button 1.1, screen 2. So if it has something that shows up on screen 2, which these all only show up on screen 2, then it'll go over here. And then I have a separate view at 133, which goes just to screen 3. And that's view button 1.11. And it recalls the same thing. So each one of these macros recalls a different view to each view button, essentially. So if we go back to our song 1 view button, and then we go to song 2, it'll call things starting at song 2 on this view. And then over here, it calls song 2 sequence to our view. Cool. I hope that makes sense. So yeah, that's really the full extent of everything here. I accidentally pulled something up that I don't want over here, so we'll just get rid of that. Whatever. That doesn't matter. But either way, I also have a layout view over here, because that's always useful for doing programming. And I have, like, all presets over here. And then I also like to have sequence content. So if I have, like, a sequence going, then I like to have the content up here. And then a command, line feedback, just to make sure there are no errors within my command. The last thing I'll go through is I like to have fixed faders and a couple fixed executors, so like crowd bumps and just like fixed things like a walk-in look, a talking in between songs look, and then downstage wash and crowd look. And it's really simple to make. I just have a completely separate page past all these that has that, and it's just, all you have to do is just type in fix, and then press your executor, and then it does that. But you have to make sure you are actually typing it. But you just type in fix, press the executor, and then it does that. Obviously it didn't do that there because I already had it fixed. So yeah, doesn't really matter, because just trust me, if you didn't have that already fixed, then it would do that. Aside from that, that's pretty much all I have in my file.
Thanks again for watching this video, and I'm gonna link a couple videos in the description that really helped me with learning a lot of this stuff, because honestly I really learned pretty much everything, especially about MA, just from the internet, because I really haven't had anybody out here to teach me that stuff. So yeah, I hope that this is helpful, and I hope to get some more content out in the future. Again, thank you for watching.